Hey YouTube, Ravi here. So, if you are just getting started into electronics, then soldering is probably not what you wanna get into on your first day. That's where the solderless breadboard comes in. Let's see how to use it. This is generally how all the breadboards look like. They come in different sizes and colors, but they work in the same way. All breadboards have generally two parts. There are the side rails on both sides, which are your power lines. They are connected horizontally all along the breadboard. And there is the middle part, which is your prototyping space. These rows are connected vertically, though not along the middle gap. This groove is where you put an IC. This breadboard is a 800 point breadboard, that is, there are 800 points or holes to put your components in. These holes are just the right size to accommodate wires, LEDs or other components. Generally, the back of the breadboard have double-sided tape so that you can stick them to a surface to keep them from slipping or moving around while making connections or changing components. With that heavenly knowledge aside, let's make a simple circuit. And what's better than turning on an LED? You'll need a breadboard, a LED of course. I'm using a 5mm white LED, a 100 ohm resistor and some wires. I'll be using breadboard jumper wires, but you can use any normal wires just stripped at the ends. And finally, a power source. You can use anything for this, a battery or an Arduino or Raspberry Pi. But I prefer this. This is a breadboard power supply. It costs less than a dollar and is really handy and easy to use while working with the breadboards. You can even power an Arduino with it using the USB port. So let's get to the circuit. Put one end of the 100 ohm resistor in the positive power rail of the breadboard and the other one in any row you like. Put the positive end of the LED, that is the longer lead of the LED, in the same row as the resistor and the negative end in an adjacent row. Don't put both the ends of the LED in the same row. Now take a wire and put its one end in the row with the negative lead of the LED. Put the other end in the ground rail of the breadboard. You can now connect your power source. Try not to use anything higher than 5 volts. Let's turn the circuit on. And it works. Simple as that, we have made a working and reliable circuit without soldering or twisting any wires. The beauty of using a breadboard is that if you wanna replace a component, you can just take it out and put in another one without disturbing the rest of the circuit. So you see, breadboard is a must-have. If you are into electronics and you want to test circuits or try out new ones, then breadboard is a really handy component. For example, in this circuit, if I want to replace an LED because just I don't like the color, I can simply do so without disturbing the rest of it. If the resistor burnt out or you want to try a lower value, that's easy to replace too. Thanks for watching. Drop a like if you liked it. Subscribe for more. See you in the next one.